The children of today will make the India of tomorrow. With this, I wish everyone a very good morning and welcome you to the virtual celebration of Children's Day. As we all agree that children are the brightest sunshine of the society, they are the perfect mirrors of their parents and, very importantly, the future of our country. So on behalf of the entire Zebedean family, I would like to wish our dear students a very virtual yet a very happy Children's Day. We really miss you a lot. Even Chacha Nehru could not deprive himself of the innocence and love for children. As a result, 14th November, the birth anniversary of the great Indian freedom fighter and our first Prime Minister of India is celebrated as Children's Day all over the world. So without any further delay, let's start this virtual celebration of Children's Day. First of all, I would like to request our esteemed Principal Sir, Mr. Prashant Kumar Das, to please spread the light of innocence, love and truth in our heart, just like a child, by lighting up the lamp, accompanied by the group of teachers.
Let's start.
Oh,
पड़ गला स्लिप हो गला
मैया ज्योति मंगल का।
evening performance. Now I would like to request my fellow colleagues to express their feelings on this beautiful occasion. Ma'am, please.
The child is a beam of sunlight from the infinite and eternal, with the possibility of virtue and vice, but as yet unstained. It's my immense opportunity to address you on this momentous occasion of Children's Day. A grand good morning. Esteemed Principal Sir, respected colleague, and my dear children. Children are the most precious treasure of our country. You will be future leaders, students, scientists, doctors, engineers, and teachers. Everybody except from you to bring about radical transformation in the country and also in the world by devising means of development and prosperity for all human beings. My dear little friends, you are not little. In this young age, you have full ton of energy and power. The success is not related with age. The first and the foremost duty of yours is to do work, whatever is assigned on you by your parents, teachers, and society. As Nelson Mandela says, our children are greatest treasure. They are our future. Those who abuse them tear at the fabric of our society and weaken our nation. This time, when you all are very far away from the school and from us, but still then we all are connected with each other through online classes. So there is no power which can break the bond between our children and us. So on behalf of all sins of our family, Happy Children's Day to all of you. Thank you.
And now, the most awaited part of the celebration. So students, be ready, as here come your teachers to make you rock and roll. All the very best teachers. Everyone.
Okay, very good afternoon to all the teachers without any children. It's a regular practice. Every year we celebrate Children's Day. But there is a concept in our mind. What is that? Children are thinking that Children's Day is coming. One day school will be off. Lots of fun, singing, dancing. So many things will be going on. And we'll keep on shouting. That part is missing today because nobody is there. And teachers also eagerly waiting for Children's Day, what we are going to perform. And we will also show them that means we are also not less than you. That means we can step one step ahead, that means as compared to you children. But all these things are stuff today, nothing is there. Simply we remember the performance of the previous years. Situation is something different. We have to adjust ourselves. Children, you must be sitting at home. That's why there is a small presentation, virtual presentation you can say, on behalf of your teachers. Children's Day is not only that means what happened, a holiday or an off day for the teachers and the students. Once in a year when it comes, it reminds us, teachers, be careful about your job and responsibility. Because the whole year we are busy in teaching and with our regular routine works. We didn't, and frankly speaking, we don't get time to think about what are the responsibilities. We are working without giving any comma and full stop for the betterment of the children. So what this day reminds us, because we know that we celebrate this day to remember the birthday of our first Prime Minister Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. But you know, Children's Day was also getting celebrated before the death of Chacha Nehru. It started in 1956, 20th November. So 20th November was celebrated as Children's Day. But after the death of our first Prime Minister, Chacha Nehru, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, we started celebrating Children's Day on 14th November as a token of love, because he loves children so much. At the same time, he was very much worried about the education of the children. The concept was no child is born to be a failure. So that's why proper education is needed, proper health is needed, proper food is needed. Now, to what extent we have been succeeded in all these areas? This day reminds us whether we are devoting our time 100% for the betterment of the children or not. Because they are the future citizens of this country. They are the future citizens of this world. Today, the place where we are standing, tomorrow when they will be coming up to this level, they should be standing in a better place as compared to us. So whether we are working on that or not, we are sincere in our work or not, we are honest in our work or not, or only for the namesake we are coming to the school and we are just going away. Celebration is what's one side, and our job and responsibility, whatever it is coming on our way, it is on another side. So both should be given proper weightage, then only that means what happened, the society can come up to a particular level and we can compete ourselves with others. And children, you must be preparing yourself for tomorrow, because tomorrow is Diwali. But this year's Diwali will also be observed or celebrated in a different way. No crackers. But don't think that crackers are not there means Diwali will be colorless. Diwali is the celebration of light. So just what happened, decorate your home, decorate your streets, decorate your surroundings in such a way that everybody will feel that yes, how light, colorful is. So once again, thank you very much for keeping yourself within your control since the last 7 to 8 months. Because from March we have not seen you, you have not seen us also. Only virtually we are meeting when the classes are going on. But hats off to you and your parents. And you are attending all the classes. And we have already covered up the syllabus according to our expectation. And we have conducted the examination also. And we are preparing the result, and we found that all of you have done very well. Very soon we are going to provide you the report cards. But accept this situation also, because this is also part of life. Because nobody knew about this kind of situation, but all of a sudden when it comes, everybody has accepted, and we are waiting, that means when the school is going to open, because without you children, the school is not a school. So school will be looking like a school, we will feel like working, you will feel like studying, when you will be coming here, and we will also be coming here, we will be interacting. And most of the times, you know, that means some of you are very much disheartened because the teachers are giving you punishment, teachers are informing your parents. And you feel that parents are your first enemy, then after that what happened, teachers are your second enemies. Why? Because parents are sending to school, asking them always study, study, study. And teachers are always running behind you people also. That means only study, study. As if there is nothing there in the life other than study. Just see, whatever we are doing, your parents are doing, that is only for your betterment. If you have work hard today, then your rest part of your life will be very much colorful. But if you are neglecting yourself today, then your future will be in dark. So basically nobody will like to go into dark. So that's why work hard, accept yourself in this situation, follow the COVID guidelines, and be good children. And once again, a very happy Children's Day. The way that means Children's Day reminds us about our job and responsibilities. In the same way, along with your observation and celebrations, it reminds you about your job and your responsibilities also. So take it seriously and be a good human being. So thank you very much once again, and a happy Children's Day.
Thank you.
was beautiful piece of art will definitely cherish this forever and ever. As all good things must come to an end, so now it's time for us to say you goodbye. But before that, I would like to request Academic Supervisor Lopa Ma'am to please give away the vote of thanks. Ma'am, please.
A very good afternoon to all of you. Respected Principal Sir, my colleagues and my dear students. It's my privilege to have been asked to propose a vote of thanks on the special occasion of Children's Day. In India, every year we observe Children's Day on 14th November as a tribute to our first Prime Minister, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, popularly known as Chacha Nehru, who was very fond of children. Children are just like the birds of the garden, to whom we should nurture carefully and lovingly, as they are the future citizen of our country. So now we have reached at the end of the program. A very happy Children's Day to all of you, my dear students. So I extend my heartfelt thanks to esteemed Principal Sir, who in spite of his busy schedule, spared his valuable time to organize this program so nicely. My sincere thanks goes to all my teachers and my faculty members who worked hard to make this program a successful one. At last, my thanks goes to all Didis and Ayas who helped us a lot to arrange this program. Thank you.